Good day everybody. In this video I'm going to explain the concept of relative density, the one that we typically use for coarse-grained material like sand. So even though it's called density, it's not density. We don't use units for density, something like grams per cubic centimeters. So this is actually shows how loose or dense the sandy soil is in the field. And let's look at this example, the one that is shown here. We have a sand backfill, and then when we measured the void ratio of that sand, the one that we put as a backfill, it was 0.581. So, and this is what we called in situ void ratio. I'm going to write it here, in situ void ratio, and that will be 0.581. So the thing is that if we take the soil, this backfill, and if we test it in the laboratory, and if we try our best to make the loosest structure of that soil packing, then we're going to have a relatively high void ratio for this sand of 0.642. And the soil structure will be like this when we have lots of voids here. So that's why we call it the loosest packing. Or after that, we can try our best and make very dense packing, the densest possible, out of the same soil. Something that is shown here, you see that there is still some voids in between solid particles, but the voids are much smaller compared to this loosest packing. So, and for this case, the void ratio, if we measure it, is going to be 0.462. So it's here values. So what we need to do, we need to decide the void ratio of the sand in situ. It's somewhere in between. So is it closer to the densest or is it close to the loosest packing there? So this is what we use relative density for this purpose. And this is what we do in this exercise. We're going to estimate the relative density right now. So to estimate the relative density, we use these two formulas. So most of the time we use this formula. So when we have this void ratio, maximum void ratio, this is minimum void ratio, and this is the void ratio of the sand in situ. There's another way to estimate relative density when we use either dry unit weight or dry density. So this is the formula, but we don't use it very commonly in practice. So, and the relative density, usually it comes as percentage, so we multiply by 100%. So why we do that? We can after that classify the soil sand based on its relative density. And this is the table that we use. So that will be the numbers of relative density. And this is descriptive terms that we use to classify the sand. Where do we use it in practice? We use it very commonly for liquefaction to estimate the potential of sand to liquefy. According to lots of studies and experience, when sand is in a relatively loose state, when it has very low relative density, most likely is going to liquefy during earthquake, or I don't know, maybe during rapid loading when there's undrained conditions. So this is very commonly used to study the liquefaction potential of sand. And let's look at this example and see if this sand backfill is going to liquefy or not. We just assume that there will be a relatively strong earthquake, and then we'll see how loose or dense this backfill is. So we're going to use the formula, and I'm going to write it here that relative density, it's maximum void ratio. In this case, it's 0.642. So when we have the loosest state, it will give us the maximum void ratio. We're going to subtract void ratio of that backfill sand, which we have it in situ, and is going to be 581. And we're going to divide by the difference between maximum void ratio and minimum void ratio, 462. And then we multiply by 100% so that we have the value in percentage. So that will give us about 33.9%. Now let's look at the table, see where this number is. So it's in this range. So it's 33.9. So we define this as a loose material. So if you have a relatively strong earthquake, so most likely then this sand backfill would liquefy. So that's how we use relative density. That's the physical meaning of density and how we use it in practice. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.